Breaking news. Secret Service agent just went all in. Obama is done. After the FISA memo news was released, a former secret agent named Dan Bongino adds to the accusations of corruption against Barack Hussein Obama. The former Secret Service agent and conservative radio talk show host, Dan Bongino, who served in the White House from 2006 to 2011 under both Presidents George W. Bush and Barack Hussein Obama, believes this could be the evidence that will finally change the public's view of Obama and show the world how corrupt this evil man really is. Bongino also has predicted that to distract from what was actually in the memo, those opposed to releasing it would likely attack Nunes personally. "We don't fully know what is contained in the actual memo, but we can predict with some certainty that it has to have something to do with the manner in which the CIA and DOJ spied on American citizens. The rumors also suggest that it has something to do with the discredited work of the Clinton campaign, who likely paid for Trump dossier. The info may reveal how it came about and who were the people behind its creation. However, it's all speculation and rumors, since no member of Congress can give us much more information about the contents without getting into trouble for releasing top secret information. For now, we're stuck with possibilities and have to piece the puzzle together on our own." The Los Angeles Times reports. Secret House Republican memo causes new rifts over Russia investigation. IPO 593126 3. Republican representative from California and embattled chairman of the House Intelligence. House Intelligence Chairman Devin Nunes, Art Allaire, worked on a confidential and controversial memo involving how the Department of Justice pursued the Russia investigation. Jim Loscalzo, EPA. Chris Medjurian, Chris Medjurian Contact Reporter. Conservative Republicans are pushing to release a memo containing classified information about the federal investigation into Russian meddling in the 2016 campaign, sparking new controversy in a case that has already caused deep partisan rifts. The contents of the four-page memo, which was written by staff working with Representative Devin Nunes, Art Allaire, who chairs the House Intelligence Committee, have not been publicly revealed. But President Trump's allies in Congress say that they are explosive. "It's some of the most alarming things I've ever read, and every single American citizen should be able to read that material as soon as possible," said Representative Jim Jordan, Republican Ohio. Democrats on the committee have dismissed the memo as a dishonest attempt to undermine the Russia investigation, and Representative Jackie Speier, D. Hillsborough, called it a pack of lies. Republicans have repeatedly said the Russia investigation, currently led by Special Counsel Robert S. Mueller III, has been undermined by partisan bias. Mueller was appointed last May after Trump fired FBI Director James Comey. Representative Devin Nunes plays defense for Trump by going on hard offense against Justice Department. Freedom Caucus members asked House Speaker Paul Ryan to support releasing the memo during Thursday night negotiations over the federal budget. Ryan deferred the issue to the House Intelligence Committee, which made it available to every member of Congress this week. It was unclear Friday whether the GOP-led House committee would hold a vote that would lay the groundwork for making the memo public. Not everyone in Ryan's caucus wants it out. Representative Mike Conaway, Republican Texas, who is leading the House Intelligence Committee's inquiry into Russia's role in the 2016 election, said it would be real dangerous to release the memo because it includes classified information. The document is the result of Nunes probing how the Department of Justice handled the Russia investigation. Nunes has said his work has uncovered serious problems involving the use of secret surveillance powers. "I believe there's evidence that abuses have occurred," he told Fox News last month. It wasn't immediately clear if the memo also looked at Republican claims that Mueller's criminal investigation has been undermined by partisan bias. The reaction to the memo was sharply split along party lines. Representative Matt Gaetz, Republican Florida, said the information was jaw-dropping. Representative Dara Lissa, R. Vista, said Americans would be outraged if they read the memo. Jay Sekulow, one of Trump's personal lawyers, said on his radio show Friday that it appears the memo reveals corruption that's breathtaking in scope. Sekulow has previously called for the appointment of a second special counsel to investigate the Department of Justice. But Representative Eric Swalwell, D. Dublin, another committee member, said the memo was filled with misinformation and should not be released. "It is a perversion of the facts to brainwash our members and protect the president," he said. "Tragically, this is what happens when the American voting populace is convinced into electing a person with a highly questionable and mysterious past. He sometimes went by different names. Should someone be allowed to run for president if they had their college transcripts and birth certificate sealed? We may not ever know the truth about who he was or where he is from. Maybe now everyone will learn of the dangers of electing a president because of his skin color over the content of character. What do you think about this? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section. Don't you forget like, share and subscribe latest news today channel. Thank you for watching.